Hi guys, myself Neha Gupta, your mentor for current affairs. I hope that you all are doing very well in terms of your health as well as your preparation. So let's begin this video without wasting any time. That is going to definitely help you in your examinations of banks like RBI, SEBI, NABARD or any kind of banking exam. So let's begin this video. But the people who are coming for the first time, it would be appreciable if you guys subscribe this channel and hit this bell notification so that you get the instant updates about the new uploads that we make on our channel. Also, this is the Telegram group for you guys only. You can join this group and ask your queries related to the content or syllabus that we provide for banking exams. The link of this group is in description below, so you can join the group from there. This is the first question for the session. With which country has India launched a bilateral fast-track mechanism in investment? So this news is very simple, guys. India has established this mechanism in order to boost investment. Now, with which country has India established this mechanism? It is with France. So the capital of France is the place where Eiffel Tower is located. So it is Paris. Currency is euro. So these are the very simple things, very simple static facts that you should be aware of about France. Now the third static part that you should keep in your mind is the president of France. So guys, can you tell me that who is the president of France? This is your question to tell me in the comment section below. Next question is, which state has signed an MOU with International Digital Health and Artificial Intelligence Research Collaborative for development of digital technologies in the state's health sector? So here are five options given: Rajasthan, Madhya Pradesh, Tamil Nadu, Punjab, Himachal Pradesh. Out of these five options, the right answer is Punjab. Punjab has signed this MOU with International Digital Health and Artificial Intelligence Research Collaborative for the development of digital technologies in the state's health sector. So clearly the purpose is to digitalize the health sector. We also have a national mission for the same purpose, that is National Digital Health Mission. So this is a step forward towards that mission by the state government of Punjab. Now guys, you would be thinking about this international collaborative. So this collaborative was announced in the year 2019. So it is very fresh, or we can say very new initiative. So it can be asked in the examination. Which organization announced it? It was Foundation Bontor. This organization has announced this initiative, and currently this initiative is hosted at this institute, General Institute in International and Development Studies, which is in Geneva, Switzerland. So remember these facts regarding this international initiative. Now, apart from this, there is one thing that you should keep in mind, that is that this initiative has not been formally launched yet. The launch date for this International Digital Health Initiative is 2022. So currently this initiative is in its incubation stage, and by the year 2022 it is expected to be launched formally, and it will start its work, which is there, which is assigned for this international collaborative. So that's all for this question. Now let's move on to the next question. Which country has the highest number of educated migrants in OECD countries? First of all, what is OECD countries? OECD is the forum or is the organization for economic cooperation and development. So this is the full form of OECD. And there is the recent data that has been released and that states that in OECD countries, the highest number of educated people are of Indian origin. Remember, guys, that we are talking about the migrants here. Highest number of educated migrants. So out of the total migrants, the highest number of educated migrants belong to India or of Indian origin. Now, how many is the total number or is the total percentage? The percentage is 65%. So out of the total highly educated migrants which are there in OECD countries, 65% belong to India or they are of Indian origin. Now, what is the exact number and which country succeed India? Let's find that out in the next slide. So guys, here is the very informative and interesting picture in front of us, which states that India has the total number of 3.12 million people in OECD countries. And remember, guys, that this is the data of 2015 to 2016. So years remember करना बहुत जरूरी है for your knowledge. Sources OECD. So this is the data from, this is the picture from OECD itself. The country that succeeds, India is China at the second number. Then we have Philippines, UK, Germany, Poland, Mexico, Russia. Just remember India and China. So these are the two major countries in Asia, and these countries belong, these countries constitute the highest number of educated people in OECD countries. Now, guys, you would be thinking that we are talking so much about OECD countries, but we don't know how many countries are members of OECD. So let me resolve that query for you. OECD has a total number of 37 countries. Remember the number of countries that are there in OECD. Now, I have told you one question. Now it's time for you guys to tell me the remaining questions, the answers of the remaining questions. So what are the remaining questions? Establishment year of OECD, president and headquarters. So these are some of the static facts related to OECD that you should be aware of, and that these are your questions that you are going to tell me in the comment section below. Which of the following company has announced to buy IHS Markit? Guys, IHS Markit is a very important company and it gives the data on market analysis. So therefore, IHS Markit is important. Do you know where is this located? Is it an Indian company? The answer is no. It is located in London. So it's a London-based company. And one of the rating agencies among the options has announced to buy this. So if you are a daily follower of current affairs, then you would know that which company out of these options is the rating agency. It is S&P Global. Goldman Sachs and Nomura are also the rating agencies, but the answer here is S&P Global, which is a US-based forecast teller. It's a GDP forecast teller. It researches in different kinds of financial sectors, and it also gives GDP forecast for India as well. So this is a US-based company which has announced to buy this IHS Markit, and there are high chances that the acquisition can be completed in few months. So that's all for this question. Now my question for you is that you have to tell me the CEO of S&P Global. This is your task. Who has been appointed as the brand ambassador for the British Academy of Film and Television Arts Breakthrough Initiative? So first of all, this breakthrough initiative was launched in India by BAFTA, and under this breakthrough initiative, five individuals from the film and television fraternity will be selected for training under BAFTA. So this in under this initiative, A.R. Rahman has been appointed as the brand ambassador. Remember this thing, 5 individuals will be selected in the film from the film and TV fraternity from India under this BAFTA initiative, which is Breakthrough Initiative, which is named as Breakthrough Initiative. That's all for this question. A very simple question it is. Nothing much to be discussed here. Next question is again a very simple question of appointment. So who is the CEO of Bata? Bata shoes to sabne pehne honge. So kaun hai wo person jisko ab global level pe CEO banaya gaya Bata ka? And remember that the person in question is the first Indian to be appointed as a CEO of Bata at global level. So now you would assume the importance of this question. Now who is that person? It is Sandeep Kataria. Remember his name? He was earlier the CEO of Bata India, and now he has been promoted at the global level, and now he is the CEO of Bata Group. Remember this thing, he is the first Indian. Where is the headquarter of Bata? Do you guys know that question? If you know, then do tell me in the comment section below, and if you don't know, then find it out and then tell me in the comment section below. So this is a static question which has stemmed from the current affairs. There is this Mount Ililivo. So this is an Indonesian name. The right answer is Indonesia. Mount Lee Levetlock located. So this is the name of this mountain. This is the name of this volcano that has recently erupted in Indonesia. Remember this name and the country where is it located? Where it is located, it can be asked in the examination. Now guys, what is the capital and currency of Indonesia? These are the two questions for you that you have to tell me in the comment section below. Thank you so much for watching this video till this end, and I hope that you will come again for the morning tales tomorrow. All the best, good luck.